So, I mean, this is a big night for everybody, but I mean, I feel like the four-way women's match is one of the things that people are going to be talking about coming out of this show. How important is that for you that on such a stacked card that this is going to be one of the matches that people remember?
I certainly hope it's something they remember, and it's so important, but it just kind of follows the path and the trend that All Elite Wrestling has set for the fans, because they value women's wrestling just as much as they do the men's wrestling, and the women superstars are featured and showcased just as much as the men superstar, and I think that setting that stage for equality in wrestling, the fans have no choice, but they're going to remember, they're going to, you know, get excited for it, and I think we're really lucky to be here in AEW with the mentality they have.
Was the chaos that came out of the match being made a fatal four-way at the last minute, did that chaos give you a better opportunity to capitalize and win?
It definitely throws me off my game, because as somebody that's, you know, values education, I study everything, wrestlers, you know, matches, past matches. So for me, having someone come out that I obviously didn't prepare for, maybe put me at a disadvantage, but at the same time, obviously, I still came out on top. So we can say, hey, maybe it played to my advantage, maybe it didn't, but at the end of the day, I still won.
Did Brandi Rhodes make a mistake tonight? Because this was not billed as a fatal four-way match, and you were not expecting to go up against Awesome Kong tonight.
I don't really know what kind of, you know, game Brandi Rhodes is trying to play, but at the end of the day, like I said, I still won. So she can go out there and find anybody to throw in the ring with me, and I'm still going to be the top girl at AEW.
Brett, I wanted to ask you about, you know, we saw women main event in wrestling shows. It's become a thing this year in particular. Is that something that's important for you as we go forward, as the TV show comes in, that women get an opportunity to main event?
Sure, absolutely. I just think giving them a stage, a showcase, time, that's all you need. Because women's wrestling is amazing right now. There's so many fantastic, amazing women's wrestlers across the world. Give them a stage, let them show you what they can do, and they will.
Can you walk us through the emotions that you have for today, starting when you woke up? I mean, did you even get any sleep last night? Let's start there.
No, I didn't. I literally got 4 hours of sleep. My family's here, my friend's here, my brother's here, the first time he ever got to see me wrestle ever, because he's in med school. He can't get out of med school ever. So just having my family, friends here is amazing. My boyfriend is at home watching. He's also a wrestler. And just having the support of everybody you love, and then coming out on top, and everyone, the feedback on social media has been amazing. Like, our fans are the best, because they don't want to see us fail, they want to see us succeed, and their you know, passion is electric, and it's so contagious for us as the wrestlers, because we're here for you, we're here for the fans.
Dr. Baker, are you the uncrowned AEW Women's Champion?
I think I would have to win a match first, right? So a title match. I'm not about free gifts or anything like that. I'm more than willing to work for any title that's in the future, but I certainly hope I'd be considered for something like that if and when it comes.